What's up, Patriots? Constitution Vet coming to you live in the field. Today's episode is going to be a little bit different. We all know teaching has its own benefits. You get to educate the next generation or the current generation. You spend time teaching someone and you see the fruits of your labor come again and again and again. The art of teaching is a skill that not many have, but if you can master it, the rewards are endless. However, teaching can also be exhausting. There could be days where you go into work, you go to your classroom, wherever it may be, and you just don't feel 100%. There will be those days where you are battling your own demons, where you're trying to get through your own struggles, and you're expected to be a mentor, a leader, a teacher to these students. So how do you get through those days? How do you remind yourself that what you're doing is worth something? How do you remind yourself that you, the teacher, are worth something? How do you get through those moments? What you're about to see is a clip from a video that I've used on those days where I do not feel 100%, where I am filled with stress, worry, anxiety. This reminds me the why behind my craft.
Now, my class, you will learn to think for yourselves again. You will learn to savor words and language.
No matter what anybody tells you, words and ideas can change the world. We don't read and write poetry because it's cute. We read and write poetry because we are members of the human race, and the human race is filled with passion. Medicine, law, business, engineering, these are noble pursuits and necessary to sustain life. But poetry, beauty, romance, love, these are what we stay alive for. Whitman, O me, O life, of the questions, of these recurring, of the endless trains of the faithless, of cities filled with the foolish. What good amid these, O me, O life? Answer, that you are here. Life exists and identity. And the powerful play goes on and you may contribute a verse. Will your verse be?
You must strive to find your own voice. The longer you wait to begin, the less likely you are to find it at all. Thoreau said most men lead lives of quiet desperation. Don't be resigned to that. Break out. Conformity, the difficulty in maintaining your own belief in the face of others. For those of you, I see the look in your eyes like, I would have walked differently. Well, ask yourselves why you are clapping. And we all have a great need for acceptance. You must trust that your beliefs are unique, your own, even though others may think them odd or unpopular, even though the herd may go, that's bad. Robert Frost said, two roads diverged in the wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference.
There are thousands of resources out there that can help us get through those tough days. Ultimately, though, we gotta remind ourselves who's really in charge. It's not you, it's not me, it's not amazing actors who play amazing roles. It's our real commander-in-chief. It's our God. And if any practical thing doesn't work for you, remember that Christ is always with you. And Christ will always get you through whatever tribulation you're going through. You're not alone in this, Patriots. Never surrender, never submit. This Constitution Vet, signing out.